I started to see many videos about software engineers and companies migrating from microservices architecture to monolithic architecture. I researched the reasons for this change. By the end of this video, you will learn the results of my research and the big secret that Amazon doesn't want you to know. You can see the resources I have used in the description. Let's dive in. Before we continue, I want you to know that this channel is all about growing as software engineers together. If you want to join, subscribe now. Let's start from the beginning. Why did companies and software engineers stop using the monolithic architecture? The answer is simple. They wanted to decouple the code bases that they work on. Projects were divided into small, independent services that could be easily managed. Also, teams working on these different services chose the stack that they wanted. This led to polyglot software projects. Well, you might think, what's wrong with that? Software engineers are well aware that everything is all about trade-offs in the software development world. Software development teams decoupled projects, but the cost of the projects increased dramatically because these projects are generally deployed to cloud services. Furthermore, network latency became a problem in microservices. On the other hand, in monolith applications, function calls are nanosecond level operations. This leads to fewer errors due to the network and slightly more responsive apps. Now, let's reveal Amazon's big secret. As you know, Amazon is a cloud-native company, so it always states how good microservices are. Initially, they used to use microservices architecture for their Prime Video service. However, an engineer from their software development team explained in a blog post on the company's website how they reduced the cost by 90% by switching from a microservices architecture to a monolith architecture. Of course, the blog post is no longer available on their website, but every tech nerd knows that the internet never forgets. You can see the Internet Archive link of the removed blog post in the description. Amazon is not the only company that switched to a monolithic architecture. A startup called TaskJet also migrated to a monolithic architecture after the difficulties they experienced. So, what do software engineers use now? Did they return to the spaghetti monolith? Of course not. The destination of the migration is the modular monolith. A modular monolith is a single deployment unit where the internal code is strictly organized into domain-centric modules with enforced boundaries. You can see the differences between spaghetti monolith, modular monolith, and microservices in this table. The modular monolith offers roughly 80% of the benefits of microservices with only 10% of the cost. You may be wondering which architecture is the best for startups. Of course, the answer is a monolithic architecture. Many experts such as Martin Fowler, Sam Newman, and Kelsey Hightower state that starting with microservices is always a big mistake for startups and new projects. So, what is the right time to switch to microservices? This should only occur when a specific problem cannot be solved with a monolithic architecture. For example, if your monolithic application is implemented using Node.js, and you need a different technology stack, such as Python for machine learning, you can think of utilizing microservices. In conclusion, microservices and monolithic architecture are widely used software development architectures in the industry. While microservices architecture costs more and is more complex, it is necessary for some situations that we discussed earlier. On the other hand, monolithic architecture is more straightforward and therefore, new projects and startups should start with it. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed the video, like it and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next one.